If you didn't play guitar, what instrument would you play?
It's almost impossible to answer. Mm-hmm. I mean, prior to when I saw the Ed Sullivan Show, if you know what I mean, mm-hmm. I had my eye on a career in comedy. I really was into Phil Silvers, Jack Benny, Red Skelton, Ernie Kovacs was my favorite. Mm-hmm. But as my parents told me, can you see Tom Petty doing anything but what he does? Mm-hmm. Huh? Mm-hmm. Can you? Mm-hmm. Can you see him as an insurance agent?
No.
Can you see Keith Richards doing anything but what he does?
No.
You got it?
Yeah.
So about 1970, my parents came to me and said one word. They said to me, I'm laying on a couch in the basement. They said one word. You know what the word was? When. You talk like a rock star. You dress like a rock star. You stay up all night like rock stars. You think you are a rock star. When are you gonna go out and be a rock star? See, I was pretty lazy. And my mother chimed and said, George, you gotta do this, because George, you know you can't work. Mm. So I said, well, okay, I got no choice. Okay, yep. No choice.
Mom said.
Yeah, that's right. So work was not for me.
Yeah, so let's imagine this. So say the guitar doesn't exist as an instrument.
If that 125 didn't exist, we wouldn't be sitting here talking. Because I went through a lot of guitars, and I had enough people encouraging me to go electric as opposed to playing acoustic, which I was trying to do. I can't even say I did a fair job of it, but I had some chops and had a right ear. So I had other people, Robert Lockwood, people in Hound Dog Taylor's band, and other people too as well, would come and say, you get an electric guitar and a bass player and a drummer, and you can take this thing as far as you want it. So I wanted to do that. Luckily, I found the Gibson 125. I have a unique style. I finger pick, like you're turning a doorknob. Mm-hmm. And I'm from playing acoustic guitar. I don't flat pick. I can't hold on to a pick. It falls out of my hands. Trust me, fellas, if I hadn't have found that instrument, I don't know what I would have done. Because mm-hmm. That's why I went and bought several of them. Mm-hmm. So if that guitar hadn't have showed up, God save me. Jeff Simon, our drummer, and that guitar showed up both at the same time.
Wow.
And that's what did it. I said, those two elements is where I woke up, and that's where I really became myself. Mm-hmm. I found myself through that. Mm-hmm. So I was fortunate on both sides of the fence.
Wow.
So now I play an Epiphone, which is designed like the 125.
Right. It looks very similar.
Yes, it is, yeah.
Wow. So timing is everything, right, George?
Timing is everything in show business and pregnancy.
Indeed. We'll leave it there.
Okay.